Topic today I'm going to take in consideration as a normal probability curve. What is my normal? So when we can talk about the normal, for example, I may tell us Muzzammil is a normal boy. What is the Muzzammil? What is the terms the Muzzammil is normal? Any people give the response in the chat box. If I tell us here Muzzammil is a normal, what is mean? There is a two terms we are using, normal and abnormal. So normal means what, abnormal means what? Here the term itself, normal property curve. Yeah, so I request you only kindly give a response, because my session is based on the pure on the discussion only. You can give the response in the chat box. What it means normal, basically when I talk to the when I want to give some example, the Muzzammil is a normal boy, it means that he can manage his emotion, exactly correct. So he's like a average people, so he's able to control the emotion and he's know how to be handle the teachers and all. So it means that it is called it's not sleep, that your perceptions. So here normal means is like average boy. Suppose I may talk about Cyril is the abnormal boy in the classroom. Just for funning I'm telling, don't be take serious. Cyril is the abnormal, or he may be a funny boy in this classroom. What is the abnormal and funny showing? Because normal boy don't be make it very funny things, but the abnormal people, they may make some funny things and all. So that is called as the abnormal. But here we may talk about the normal. So it means that I'm talking about the average people, average things only. So therefore it's called as a normal probability curve. If you are taking the sample for lakhs number of people, that probability curve may comes like this. Because once you come to the classroom also, how many people are high achiever, how many people are low achiever, if you look on it, high achiever, low achiever look like the same, but the average people are much high in the classroom. It means that most of the classroom students consist of the average students. I hope all of you get it. The same thing only we are going to check through the normal probability curve. The normal probability curve is nothing but it is a distribution curve, it's a sample distribution. For example, I have in the 1 lakh students the achievement score. So if I check the achievements score of the 1,000 students or the 1 lakh students mark, after collecting that, if I put the histogram, then after converting the histogram, if I convert as a normal, what is that? Like this kind of curve. The curve may lies like this only. The curve may lies like this. Because see, this curve, it is called normal probability curve. Because the normal cases, the curve is comes like this. What it means, if you see this curve, the right side, left side from plus 2 SD to plus 3 SD, it means that high achiever. For example, I'm telling, this negative side, minus 2 SD to minus 3 SD, they are called as a low achiever. So therefore, the same ratio, the same percentage of people lies on the high achiever as well the low achiever. Come to the case of moderate level, means an average. The average only, that what is that the probability wise as well as the space wise occupying the average level only. It means that 34.13, the left side 34.13, it's the nearly 65% of people, average people, they may lie in the classroom. It means that if you take it consideration of any classroom, nearly 65% of students are average level. The remaining so in the 65, what is the remaining? So it comes to 35. The 35, if you divide into 2, so nearly what is it? 35 into divide into, it comes to since 17 years, 17.5. So it means 17.5 high achiever, 17.5 low achiever. So it is like a distribution. This is the way only the normal people dispersion may lie. Therefore, it's called as a normal probability curve. If there any queries, you can ask me. Normal probability curve means if you are taking the consideration of more sample, for the sample you are measuring anything, after measuring, if you are doing the graphical representation of this mark or measurement, you may find out this kind of exact shape of the curve only. Therefore, it's called normal probability curve. Now I'm going to talk about who generate this normal probability curve, then who is the co-founder, then who is that after following this kind of normal probability curve. That's I'm going to highlight. The normal probability curve or distributions is also called as a Gaussian distribution or normal curve. He's the man of Gauss, okay. So can you see his photo? The normal distribution was first discovered by the De Moivre in 1733 and solved problems in games or chances. Actually, when he attempted a probability for finding the solution for some games as the chances, he made this normal probability, normal distributions idea. Then after this, after discovering this, some of the mathematicians can follow the same kind of strategies. So that is the best example is Laplace. Laplace also is applying this normal probability or normal distributions idea in his natural resources research. Then finally, this concept was to be developed by the Gauss. He only divide this much of properties are available, like that he divide the lot of properties. These properties normally it comes to the examination. So don't forget, damn sure this question may come for your examination as a big question. They may highlight the question, they may ask a question like this. List of the characteristics of the normal particle, otherwise explain or describe the properties of normal particle. There is only 9 properties. It's very simple properties I'm going to emphasize now one by one. Normally the literal meaning of the term normal is average. It's called average. According to J.P. Guilford, he defined the NPC in his own way. Normal probability curve is a well-defined or well-structured mathematical curve. It's a mathematical curve. That's why it's like a probability curve shape. It's coming. It's a bell-shaped curve. It's coming. Having a distribution of scores with mean, median, and mode or equal. So in this distribution, mean, median, mode. So you already, the last semester, you may learn the method of center tendency. The methods of center tendency, mean, median, mode are there. So mean, median, mode, they may call as a method of center tendency. The same way, methods of variability, range, quartile deviation, average deviation, standard deviations, these are things we learned in the last semester. This semester, we are talking about the inference statistics as well as the descriptive statistics. But in the inference statistics, we may deal with this kind of normal probability curve only. Because reason only, the J.P. Guilford highlight that normal probability curve is well-defined. It is like a well-defined, well-structured. It is not like a freehand diagram. It will be a free, well-structured. So if you take it consideration of any higher cases, if you take it the much samples, finally that sample distribution may come this kind of shapes only. If it comes this kind of shape only, damn sure that your thesis should be correct. Otherwise, there is a problem with your research work. If you are taking the consideration of the normal people, if you are taking the abnormal people, there is a different way that answer may come. If you take in the consideration of only the normal people like us, if you are doing the research in the normal people, that output may come like this only. For example, you are taking the research for like juvenile children. Juvenile children is not a normal students. So when you consider, when you take the sample only the juvenile students, already they committed lots of mistakes because the reason only they are in the jail. So if you are observing the characteristics, it shows a lot of negative things only. So it's no, there is no positive things. And therefore, damn sure that measurement of the that kind of abnormal people, it won't become as a normal probability curve, it comes as skewness. So the next class I may talk about skewness and kurtosis, but today I'm going to talk about the normal. So it means that if you are taking the consideration only the normal people like us, if you are measuring something in the normal way, finally if you go with some kind of diagram representation, that diagram representation may come basically normal. For this, what is the first properties? Mean equal to median equal to mode. So here the mean value, median value, mode value is to be same. This is the first characteristics. So these are the characteristics you have to write the examination. The first characteristics of normal probability curve. See the normal probability curve that I under above. I given the normal probability curve. The normal probability curve, it is a normal shape. I already highlighted it's an average. Therefore, these shapes of the curve is like a bell shape. So that normally we may see the bell, no? That kind of shapes is coming. If you found out this kind of bell shapes at anywhere after doing the data collection, if you are converting the data collection in a diagram representation, if the curve is comes like this, or the curve is lies like this, you can highlight that this curve or this distribution is called normal. So based on your research only, we can find out whether your distribution satisfies the normal probability curve or not. It's not satisfying the normal probability curve. So the first property of normal probability curve, the curve should be in the format of bell. It is like a bell-shaped curve. The second property of the normal probability curve, I already mentioned that this is a normal probability curve, it's a bell-shaped. The center, see that the center only, the mean is like mean, the center points. That's why they are writing the term as a mean. So here the mean, median, mode, the three measures of center tendency may lies on the same point. because recently the second characteristics of the normal probability curve, mean equal to median equal to mode. So here the mean value, median value and mode value, if three values are same, for example, I am conducting one examinations, all 20 students. So after 20 students, I'm collecting, I'm doing the research, I'm doing the, I'm finding the mean, median, mode. The mean shows that 80 mark, median also 80 mark, mode also 80. It means that the class distribution of sample is satisfying the normality. So it means in the classroom consists of average people match, the equal of gifted student, the equal of what is the slow achievers are there. So from this we can easily understand whether that curve, the your group, whether it's to be a normality satisfied, otherwise a non-normality satisfied, it can easily come for conclusion. Therefore, second property of the normal property curve, mean equal to median equal to mode, the three values, mean, median, mode, is lies on the center point. I hope all of you get it. So the second, first characteristics is a bell-shaped, the second characteristics, mean equal to median equal to mode. Yes. I'm going to the third characteristic. What is third characteristic? It is called unimode or unimodal. So what is the mode? We already know the mode means is here, high frequency or most accurate values called as here, mode. But in this case, mode means it's like height, okay, the peakness, okay. Here the peakness is comes only one area, here only. For example, the curve I'm, if it comes, for example, in my mouse point you are getting, so there is, if the curve comes like this, see here, I'm not drawing, the mouse mark you are getting, there is a two mode, one height, then down, then one more height and down, like that. So I'm doing with the mouse pointer, if it comes two or three heights, here only one height, only topmost height is there, other things to become the mountain slope like this. But here I may get two mode, for example, two mountain near. If you get the two mountain near, that kind of shapes, it is called bimodal. So bi means two, uni means single. So in this case, normal probability curve, only one mode, it means only one mountain is there. So in this case, if you see the graph representation, you may found out that this graph will look like a mountain, but only one mountain are there. If you feel that when you seeing this curve, if you have, it look like a two mountain, for example, two height peaks are there. Therefore, it's called a bimodal. But bimodal is not a normal probability curve. Only if the curve having satisfying the only the unimode. Unimodal means only one mode. I already mentioned that mean, median, mode is high, lies on the center. Therefore, here only mode. So see, I hope all of you get my pointer. My pointer and my mouse. This is the point the mode is lying. So here only one modes are lying. Therefore, it's called unimodal. This is a property of the third properties of the normal probability curve. The fourth property is called symmetrical. Otherwise, it's called skewness equal to zero. Skewness equal to zero. Otherwise, it's called perfect symmetrical. What is the perfect symmetrical? Actually, if I cut the, and there is a normal probability curve, if I cut the curve in the center, for example, I'm cutting the curve in the center point, the mid points, I may get the 50% of scores this side, 50% of scores this side. So therefore, it is called symmetric. If you are able to divide the curve in a center, after dividing the curve, if you get it the two equal, then it's called symmetric. If it's symmetric satisfied, then it's called as yes, skewness equal to zero. Then it's called as skewness is equal to zero. I hope all of you get my voice clearly, you know? Yeah. That perfect symmetric, it means the curve inclines towards both the sides equal from the center of the curve. And thus we, suppose you are not get the voice clearly, kindly check your internet connection. The problem is here. Anita, kindly check your internet connection. Thus we can get equal halves of both sides from the central points. So once again, I tell symmetric means, if I divide, for example, you have the cake. You have the cake. How you can divide the cake into two parts? So if you cut into center, one equally two parts we may get it, no? That is called symmetric. The same way here in the normal probability curve, if you are dividing the center, we may get the 50% of scores in the left side, 50% of people are lies in the right side. So here this the mean score, the center line, no? The center line, if you're adding this scores, no, it comes 50. If you're adding this scores also 50, it comes. So this is called as perfect symmetric. Other name is called skewness value equal to zero. Yeah, this is an example. See, this is a normal property curve once again. I am debating the mu. So what is the mu? Any idea? Any people give that meaning? What is mu? Mu represent what? Why the mu is lying here? What is that symbol mu represent in statistics? Any idea? Mu represent what? Kindly give a response in the chat box. What is the mu represent? What is m represent? What is my m represent? Normally in the last semester we are talking about m. M is equal to what? M represent what? Yeah. So please give a response. Just if it's not a correct or wrong, just I want to check. Yeah, exactly. Sarai is correct. Anushree is correct. It is called mean. Actually, there is a two terms I'm going to highlight. Mu is for the population mean. Population mean. The mu, the term we can use it for the population mean. M is the terms we can use it for the sample mean. So both is mean only. If you are finding the mean for only the sample group, then it's called, then you can use the term M. If you are finding the population, mean for the population, the entire population, then you can use the term mu. Therefore, here I'm using the term mu means the population. I'm taking the population as my group. I'm doing the research for them. Then the curve may comes like this. If you divide the curve in the center, we may get 50% this side, 50% this side. It's in the 0.5% here. Therefore, it's called symmetric. The fifth property of the normal public curve is asymptotic. So what is the asymptote? Here, see the curve. Actually, in down, there is one line is called, baseline is going on. The baseline is there. In the above, there is another curve. It is a curve. Down is the baseline. So the question for you, whether the curve is touching the x-axis, so in down is baseline is called x-axis. Whether the curve is touching the baseline or x-axis, kindly give a response. Are you able to see in the graph whether, yeah, no. So that is called asymptotic. So that is the property is called asymptotic. Here, the curve, no, it won't be lies on the baseline. It won't become the zero level. So the see here, it may goes to the mean plus one sigma, second two sigma, three sigma. The end, the curve, it may goes like this only. It may goes to the infinity sigma. The same way here also minus infinity sigma, it may goes, but the curve does not touch on the x-axis. Therefore, it's called asymptotic in nature. The curve does not touch the base or x-axis or both sides. It won't be touched on both the sides. Therefore, this property is called an asymptotic in nature. The next property, the property number 6, the distance of the curve. Actually, the curve is divided into 6 sigma approach. Actually, whenever you hear the term 6 sigma, those who are the management background, they may understand what is 6 sigma. 6 sigma means it's like a normal. Like if you want to measure anything, they may tell you, he's a very good 6 sigma people. May highlight. It means it's a perfect man. Here, the same way, 6 sigma approach only. Here, the right side 3 sigma, the left side negative 3 sigma is coming. Here the ratios, what is the distance between the each sigma is to be same only. For example, minus 1 sigma to plus 1 sigma. If you see the ratio, the left side 34.13, the right side is 34.13. If you go with minus 2 sigma to plus 2 sigma, the area same. If you go with minus 3 sigma to plus 3 sigma, the area same. But I told that this lines may prolong. There is no end for this line. It may goes to the minus infinite sigma to plus infinite sigma. It never lies on the x-axis. Therefore, it's called asymptotic. But here, we are may talking about the distance, the curve between the plus or minus 1 sigma, plus or minus 2 sigma, plus or minus 3 sigma. That is called characteristics. Here, what is the distance of the what is that areas to be covered in the plus or minus sigma. For example, see here, there is minus 1 sigma, plus 1 sigma. The area is covered 34.13 plus 34.13. What is the answer? 34.13 plus 34.13. It is called 68.26. So it means that the distance of the curve, it is plus or minus 1 sigma, is 68.26. Similarly, if you go with the plus or minus 2 sigma, we have to take like this. 13.59 plus 34.13 plus 34.3 plus 13.59. If you add everything, if you add this area to this area, that score is 95.44. Therefore, the plus or minus 2 sigma area is 95.44x. What is the plus or minus 3 sigma? Surya is correct. What is the plus or minus 3 sigma area? plus or minus 3 sigma area is called 99.73. So remaining, if you see 99.73, what is the remaining? Out of 100%, what is the remaining? If 99.73 is goes in the sun, what is the remaining? It's remaining 0.27 only. So 0.27 varies slice. So kindly give a response. 0.27 varies slice. In this graph, it shows only 99.73. But we need 100%. But here the 100% is not there. Remaining 0.27% varies slice. Give your answers, Surya and any other. Because the 0.27 may divide into two parts. 0.27, what is the divide? If you go with 13 point something, it may divide into two equal parts into 0.27. Therefore, 0.13 is lies on the above the minus 3 sigma. The similarly, the 0.14, I mean 13 is round of 0.14%, it may lies on the the plus 3 sigma after this region. Therefore, all together only it comes as 100%. But we may take in consideration only the plus or minus 3 sigma only. Yes. Now, this is called distance of the curve. I'm going to highlight the distance of the curve one by one. Normally, we can round off like this. The properties of 6, we can go with the 68, 98.5 and 99.7 rule. There is a rule, there is a property also. What is 68? So if you round off, it may 68, otherwise it may come 16 point, that point it may come. Here the 34% of plus or minus 1 sigma, that is called plus or minus sigma range. Plus or minus 2 sigma, it is called 95%. Plus or minus 3 sigma, it lies on the 99.7%. From this, there only the terms is generated. What is the terms? 68, 95, and 99.7. So this is nothing but the distance of the curve. It is a sixth property is talking. The sixth property talking about the distance. If you're taking the consideration normal property curve, the normal property curve, that plus or minus one value is always 68. If you're taking the any graph, like if you're taking the 1,000 samples, the curve is comes like this, you can check it whether it will be satisfying 68. If you go with the 10,000 sample, if you go with the 1 lakh sample, if the sample distribution satisfying this property, then one is called normal, right? So this is sixth property. Now the seventh property, what's the seventh property? The seventh property is talking about the height. The sixth property is talking about the distance, like the x-axis things they are measuring, in what manner it will be spreading. But here, that this is the seventh property is talking about ordinate. I hope you may get the last semester also. I may talk about the two terms, abscissa and ordinate. What is the difference between abscissa and ordinate? Please give the answer. What is my abscissa? What is my ordinate? Abscissa represent what? For example, I have the point 3, 4 in the graph sheet. 3, 4 is a graph sheet. Yes, 3 represent what? X-axis. Y is 4. Here, the 3 number represent the abscissa. Y is called as an ordinate. So in this case, we are going normally, if you in this graph only x-axis are there. What is y-axis? That height, the height is called as a y-axis. This y-axis height only we are checking. In this case, the highest height of the 1 sigma is 0.2420. We have to memorize only the height of the plus or minus 1 sigma is 0.2420. The 2 sigma, the height of the curve is 0.0540. The similarly, the height of the 0.3 sigma, 0.00044. Just I'm going to example. See here, it's a normal property curve. The right side, the ordinates goes are there. The ordinates goes are there. Which is in 1 sigma? This is in 1 sigma. This is in 1 sigma. If I go with 1 sigma, the curve, this is a maximum height here. If I keep the cursor here, if you go parallelly, you may see the answer. See here. If I keep here, it may nearly 0.25. That is why, what is the answer? The answer is 0.2420. It's called 0.2420. But similarly, if you come to the 2 sigma, this is a 0.2 sigma. This is the height. If you keep the scale properly, you may find out the answer. It comes nearly 0.05 something. That's why it comes 0.0540. If you come with the third sigma, which is the third sigma, this is the third sigma. It is comes less than, it is in between the 0.05 to this 0.00. So it is comes less than 0.05 only. Therefore, the value of the 3 sigma is 0.0044. It is called ordinate based on the height. The previous one is based on the distances. So still now we are talking about the 7 properties. That 8th property I'm going to talk about now. So the 8th property, this thing we already discussed. The 8th property, point of infection. So the term is missing. It's called point of infection. What is my infection? So in this separate, in a particular point only, the point of infection happens. The point of inflection or inflation happens. In this, where the point of infection happened, in the sense, only that one sigma. See here. Here only the curve is changing from convex to concave. So now you know the convex, what is a concave. In this area, the curve, see here, this is my plus R one sigma. Each sigma, the curve is to be changing the convex to concave. In the mode, it will be curve, it will be changes another curve mode. That is a property number 8. So the point of infection are equal, each plus or minus one sigma. From above and below the mean. So normally the plus R1 sigma only the infection happens. See here the plus R1 sigma. Then last property. These are the properties also may satisfied in the characteristics or normal property curve. So some of the various measures are that. If you find out the quartile deviation for this kind of normal property curve, the value of the quartile deviation scores 0.6745 approximately. It is also, you should be memorized. So when you're having this kind of normal property curve, for this normal property curve based scoring, if you are checking the quartile deviation, the scores of the quartile deviation should be 0.6745 approximate value. If you're checking the mean deviation for this kind of normal property curve satisfied data, that mean deviation may come 0.7979 approximate. I already mentioned the skewness equal to 0. That's what is skewness is equal to 0. If the curve is satisfying the symmetric property, if it cuts the cut in the center, it may get the two equal parts. Therefore, it's called skewness. Normally, the skewness value of the normal property curve is 0 only. The kurtosis value is 0.268. It's nothing but height. This maximum height, because we already told, no, the height of the curve is nearly, what is that, ordinate scale. So 0.245, no? 245. There's an ordinate. Highest ordinate we are putting as a 1 sigma. So what is the 1 sigma is 0.2420. But the highest height, see here, this highest height of the normal property curve, according to the normal property curve, they highlight that if the value is 0.263. The value is 0.263. So tomorrow I may talk about the kurtosis. Kurtosis is nothing but the height. So next class I'm going to highlight what is the kurtosis. Normally in the normal property curve, the kurtosis value is 0.263. If the curve is not satisfying the 0.263, we may treat the graph as a free distribution. It is not a normal property curve. So the skewness and kurtosis I may talk about tomorrow. But in the normal property curve, the skewness is to be 0 only. Just I'm going to be highlight everything once again. This curve is called as a Gaussian curve. There's a 9 property we are discussing. The first property is a bell-shaped curve. It's a bell shape. The second property, mean equal to median equal to mode. So the three scores may lies on the center only. The third property is called unimodal. Is nothing but unimode. It means that the curve having a single mode, only one mode. That is highest. Normally mode means highest peak area, highest point where it's lying. There only the mode is lying. Therefore the center point only highest is there. See here. That's why I told mean, median, mode like based on the same point. Mode is to be known most frequent value. Most frequent value lies only there's the lysing. Then it will be perfect symmetric. Perfect symmetric means skewness equal to 0. If we cut the curve in the center, we may get the two equal area. Then it's called symmetric. And then asymptotic. What is my asymptotic in the sense? The curve does not touch on the x-axis. That is the property of asymptotic. Then distance of the curve is based on the deviation. The distance of the curve, the plus or minus 1 region, it is called 68.26%. Plus or minus 2 sigma is called 95.44%. Plus or minus 3 sigma area, 3 sigma is called 99.73. The remaining 0.27 is to be divided into 2.14.4 in the plus or minus 3 sigma after. So there only it should be lying. Then maximum ordinate is the 7th property, is based on the height of the curve. The 1 sigma, the height of the curve is 0.2420. The 2 sigma, that ordinate value is 0.0540. The 3 sigma, that height of the value, ordinate value is 0.0044. This is the 7th property. The same thing we are discussing. that the eighth property is showing that inflex. Okay, where is that point is infection? Normally, it may infect the point of the plus or minus one sigma only. There only the curve is moved to the convex to concave. And then the finally, this kind of measures also satisfied if you go with the quarter division as well as the mean division skewness kurtosis value. This is a thing we can apply in different places. That thing we may talk about later. So this is an application is that next time I may talk about in what manner we can use this kind of normal property curve. Thank you so much for